developed a lot, digital solutions, and I think they will be for good. For example, if we will join again physically the Atlantic run, I think we will make preparations. I give an example. Let's see. We will make preparations also on Zoom, some discussions, some brainstormings, and we'll be more prepared there. Of course, the peak will be on the island because we are face to face there. And for example, we have three primary means of communication that are verbal, non-verbal, and visual. All these types of communication can be put online. We have verbal communication, depends on words to deliver meaning. We have words there. We have non-verbal communication, signs, messages sent or received without the use of words, and the visual communication. We see one each other, but the difference is we don't have this egregora. My thing is, I'm thinking, how will we speak? How will we speak to each other when we will be back together? For example, in Bucharest already started some small events, 50 people, 20 people. And what I saw, the events were more warm like before the pandemic. The communication was better, the empathy. I think due to this pandemic, I afford to say due, not because of this pandemic, we will become warmer in communication face to face. Even we can be warm also online, of course. I want to tell some words about egregore. It's from French egregor, from ancient Greek egregoros, which it means wakeful. It's an occult concept. Occult doesn't mean something bad, of course. Just philosophical, representing a distinct non-physical entity that arises from a collective group of people. When we are together, we are like one being sometimes, physically. We are people, like in this case, like this, we are reacting. Of course, historically, this concept, I don't want to talk a lot about that. This concept referred to angelic beings or watchers, specific rituals, practices associated with them in the past. But egregora means when people gather together. For example, a miracle of communication is the idea of brainstorming. We put together 5-10 people. We don't criticize one each other. For example, let's organize next Atlantic run. Which are your ideas? Each one are saying his ideas. Okay, we listen. This is your idea. This is mine. And scientifically, face to face is different than online, when a small gathering is staying in the same place and they are discussing about an idea without criticizing themselves. Just like we make on Atlantic run, for example. Because in my opinion, Atlantic run, I repeat, I know, I used to repeat some ideas, this is my style, but Atlantic run means ideal communication. I remember what Mr. Alexandru Mironov told us more than 20 years ago. Atlantic run is the future for Romania, or maybe for all the world, not the only future, but one event that means the future of civil society. The way we communicate, we don't have, we are not aggressive, of course. We are not in competition, or maybe competition just for some contests is different, of course. We communicate, it's harmony. And Atlantic run is a very good example of communication in history. And it's an historical example, Atlantic run, if I think. I studied a lot, but I don't want to focus on that. But a lot of philosophers, a lot of writers studied this idea of egregora. People together sharing one purpose, one idea, one dream, let's say, but together physically, only physically, we can have egregora, not from letters like in the past.
Mm.
Even letters had a very strong impact. We all sent letters, if we remember, 30 years, 25 years ago, just written by the hand or by computer. We didn't have email internet in 90s or 80s, and they had a very strong power. But like on internet too, on letter, you cannot see the people. Now we can see one each other face to face. But it's different when we see face to face, not online, but face to face, at 1-2 meters distance. Respecting physical distance now, not social distance. I don't agree this concept of social distance. Now we don't have social distance. We are very near, very close.
That's true. It's more of a physical distance, not a social distance.
Physical, no? Yes. Yes, because we must respect one each other. We are in the pandemic, that's it, excepting families, of course, close friends. But anyway, I think in the future, it will be better. And in my opinion, from now on, we will be focused on quality more. Maybe meetings will be shorter, but more efficient. I don't mean about it. I don't mean Atlantic Run. There we are together 10 days physically. But after being, inundated with back-to-back virtual meetings and experiencing the exhaustion that comes with them, I figured out how to suffer less and make meetings as short as possible. But it doesn't matter, we won't be together also to other meetings. I think we will send the message more clear. For example, also on Atlantic Run, I imagine we can have a brilliant meeting 1 hour. Then we can stay at a beer, at a coffee. Then we have another meeting. Or not only Atlantic Run, an event, let's say. Our mind will be more, speedy, in my opinion.
So maybe we'll be more efficient and get right to the agendas, maybe more so on our virtual meetings.
I think we will have shorter professional meetings and we'll empathize than speaking at a coffee, let's say. In my opinion, for example, just an example, I don't say, wow, it's my job. I was invited more than in the past at televisions, but many of them by Zoom or Skype, not in the studio, because still pandemic. But it's not just my case. Public speaking, I think, will be easier due to Zoom. Zoom encouraged us to have the skills of public speaking easier, and it will be easier also when we'll be face to face. Also, by the way, all of us, we have emotions. We are a little bit shy. I think also the presidents sometimes can be shy, even they don't look. When you communicate, of course, you pay attention what people will say about me, what people will say about my ideas, about my look, about how I sent the messages. And I think due to online, it will be easier. The exam will be face-to-face, of course, because more and more people started to share their ideas. I have a lot of friends from tourists, from communication, very smart, very clever, but they were very shy to send the messages in front of 10 people or 100 or 1,000. For me, for example, I have some skills in communications since 20 years or more. Always I have emotions. When I sent a message, but doesn't matter if there are 10 people, 100 or 1,000. It's the same respect for the people in front of me that are listening to me. And I attended 2 years ago a conference held by a very good Romanian, very known Romanian actor. And he told me, if you don't inspire emotions, if I have always emotions. I was only once when I was younger, very angry because some other colleagues, we had some problems. And I was on the scene, on the theater, without emotions. It was very bad. Excepting that, always I put heart. Of course, I have a lot of emotions, and all the things are okay. So in communication, emotion is very good. Okay, we must control it a little bit, but it's good to be honest and to openly communicate. So I will study this, I promise. I want to focus on this public speaking, and because you know, Heather, on Atlanticron, we have a lot of people that can that have a lot of ideas, but they don't like to be in front to tell to 10 or 100 people the ideas. Mm. Even Atlanticron was a school, because a lot of people, I think, had their first public speech on Atlanticron.
Yeah.
Me, not me too. I had also before public speeches, but also on Atlanticron. And I didn't like to have a lot of public speeches, just when you want to send a message, of course.
Yeah, I think at the academy, the communication started with a lot of our very young students who had the opportunity. Of course, Sarin Rapanovich wasn't shy about bringing these young people up to the stage for them to share a talent or to share about their day or to share what they learned or an important message or that they wanted to share. So for a lot of the students who are a lot older there now, they started when they were really young. And I think it gave them a great opportunity to start to learn how to connect with an audience and how to communicate and how to be a public speaker, which doesn't always come easy for so many of us. So I think that gave them a little bit of an edge.
I totally agree, Heather. And by the way, I'm very open and honest. Some years ago, a lot of years, 15 years, more, 16 years, Sorin told me, okay, you are a fan of science fiction, but your profession is communication. Focus on communication on Atlanticron. Let's learn youth about communication. And I made, conferences and courses with the writer Aurel Carachel about journalism and communication. And I have a list with the people that we contributed, not 100%, but students that were on Atlanticron or high school, let's say teenagers, that went into communications after. And now they are good journalists, or they are on public relations, on marketing at big companies, on communication. And not me, we must be very proud about that, because you were also in the team. Sorin, for example, is a very good example of how to communicate. He's a leader in communications, and he learned how to communicate during the last 30 years, more than 30 mm-hmm. years, step by step. The communication, we learn to communicate. I have some younger people than me. I don't succeed? Why? And I told them, be patient. Communication is a skill. You can have it, but you need time. You need exercise. You need to read. You need to practice, of course.
Yeah, step that's true.
We develop ourselves. Because I remember you, Heather, always you were a very good communicator. I can tell you honestly. Mm. I know you since 2006, but now you evolved, you too, a lot. You're a good communicator, but now you can...
I still get nervous as if it was my first time, though, every time. So I guess that's nervous. A good thing. Keeps me sharp.
To be honest, hey, I was nervous before, because always I have some emotions. I put emotions.
Yeah. Yeah. And you always have nerves, you know, a little bit of nerves going on until sort of you relax a little bit.
Yes.
Yeah, it keeps us sharp. Hey, I have a question for you as a journalist. How have you seen over this past year and a half, have you seen the information that you share with your people, has that changed dramatically, or the way that you share it? Because maybe the way that you're speaking to your audience is a little bit different. So my first part of the question is, has the information changed? Like maybe you're more focused on sort of emotional connections, or is it just what's going on because of the pandemic, maybe in the world of travel and how, you know, and that's changed. So that was my first part of the question. The information, and then how you share that. Has that changed over the past year and a half?
Yes, it's changed. And thank you. You reached the theme of travel. As I saw, the information was more empathic. Okay, I am journalist, but unfortunately, over the last, all over the world, but also in Romania, over the last 20 years, the mass media became more and more tabloid, let's say, more and more, less study, more, how to say?
Like headline of
instinct,
like...
More instinct, less study.
Yeah. But
for example, mass media, I saw that it's near the travel industry and near the creation, near literature, near other businesses. Something like it's pandemic, but not forget about developing ourselves in the future. This is a very good thing. I won't join the subject about conspiracies. Of course, a part, but a small part of media was on conspiracy. I don't agree with the conspiracy thing. Okay, I agree with the conspiracy thing if all journalists make a editorial, let's say a big article with, let's say, reasons, with quotes, with arguments. But as I saw, the communication was in a good way. Journalists understood that this is the situation. All the time, journalists, and that's very good, will push on government. It's normal like this. Because the politicians must be pushed. Doesn't matter. They can be your friends, my friends, but they must be pushed. But I saw more empathy also in communication. Little bit, not totally, but it's very good. Of course, a lot of... We have a saying, I cannot... I don't know how to translate. A lot of warriors can be in front of webcam. You know, something like this. Not on face-to-face. Of course, there were also some situations, some people, doesn't matter, organizations, journalists, being pandemics, started to make war online, just with words. But they are a minority. A lot of people understood this thing. For example, in tourism and travel, the travel agencies are more cooperative now. It's an egregore also, not totally perfect, because we are speaking about business environments. Some of them can be in competition, but they are more close because or maybe due to the pandemic. And people started to be more nearby, how to say, like in the past. Not all, but better, like in the past. I think we won't forget our old habits in a good way, I mean. We'll forget about distance when the pandemic will be closed. Maybe we'll respect more. Now, it's not about communication, but maybe. Maybe we'll wear masks in public transportation. We respect more the hygiene and so on. That's a very good thing. But the social and physical approach, I don't think people will forget. Even, thanks God, I don't think, but even we'll have another 1 year of pandemic, let's hope not, I don't think people will forget the personal touch, let's say.
Yeah, I feel like for many people, they're just aching to get back into the environments where they can communicate face-to-face, where they can reach out and give someone a hug. And I think those things are so innate in us that once the mask comes off and everything gets back to a normal way of life that we used to know, that those things are just going to come back to us very quickly. Although I do have to say that you know, you still reach out when you meet a new colleague or someone, you reach out to shake their hand, and then you go, and sometimes then you pull back and then you're not quite sure what to do. So you do the elbow or fist, or, you know, put up the jazz hands or whatever. So I think we're in that space where sometimes there's a little uncertainty. And then sometimes we're reaching out to just hug our family members that we haven't seen in a while. So I think it'll be the way that we communicate with each other and that way, I think we'll, you know, maybe take a little bit of an interesting path to get back to where we used to be. But
the empathy will be better, I'm very sure.
Yeah.
And online helped us.
Oh, yeah. I agree with you.
It's just a way. But this way of online, this road will be permanently, I guess. But for preparing us for face-to-face meetings. But we don't have time. For example, it's a miracle also. We had, you remember, we have the virtual Atlantic run. I stayed, like, in my mind, the island was in my room last year. We had 5 days. And yes. I had some business only one day, but 4 days I stayed. Anyway, it was pandemic. I stayed in my home waiting for. And now we have this monthly meeting. Congratulations. It's a very good idea. I'm sure we'll have virtual Atlantic runs from now on. Maybe next year, maybe this year, we won't have an Atlantic run physically. Sorin knows better, but I think it's a phenomenon that can go on years and years with the next generation. And sorry, what I, okay, I talk too much. And now I talk too much. And now I want to speak about other thing that pandemic, some people made us to make this thing, listening. Because a listener is one of the best ways to be a good communicator. No one likes communicating, of course, with someone who cares only about putting in her 2 cents, how to say, only his 2 cents, his words, and does not take time to listen to the other person. If you are not a good listener, it's going to be hard to comprehend what you are being asked to do. And on Atlantic Run, me too, a lot of people will learn to listen. For example, okay, now I talk too much, but I tell about what paradoxical to listen on Atlantic Run.
No, it's actually a huge part. I'm glad you're mentioning it, because I think it's a huge part of communication that we don't think about. And this pandemic has kind of forced us to be better listeners. So you keep going.
You agree, yes, Heather.
I agree.
For example, okay, I'm talking too much sometimes because it's also my job. I like to talk. Anyway, I don't like to talk stupid things. Maybe I don't like. I prefer to listen or to shut up if I think I don't have to send a message. But on Atlantic Run, even we are a lot of important people. Important, not kings and queens, but people that have a purpose in their lives. And on Atlantic Run, I feel the most, humble. And I listen, and a lot of people that, me too maybe, but a lot of people have so nice and good messages there, all of us, and I learned how to listen on Atlantic Run. I'm sure about that.
Well, I agree with you, and I think platforms like this, like Zoom and stuff, have kind of forced us to take pause, because we have to take turns in listening. We can't all speak at once, right? We have to unmute or whatever it is that we have to do. So it's a big part of that. And a skill, I think, I know for myself that I'm still learning as well. So
we learn all our lives, we learn, of course.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Students, my philosophy is I'm a student all my life. I cannot say it's an end point. I learned all, of course. Come on.
You're a lifelong learner, Tryon. Lifelong learner.
Yes.
Yes. Hey, so with a few minutes that we have left, if you could give our audience a take-home message, something that you've learned from this past year, something that you want us to remember going forward about communicating post the pandemic era, what would be your message or your advice?
Confidence, study. I learned more about the value offer and the art of receiving, and it's about communication. For example, receiving, in my opinion, or rather knowing how to receive, I think is the most important gift we benefit from as people. Only after you receive, you can give. But you must know how to receive. When I'm trying to come, for example, we received a lot, and we give also. I hope so. I guess so. Sometimes we do not receive because we do not know how to receive, or because we refuse to receive. It's not our case here. In my opinion, is the principles and the standards that guide us, what we create and leave behind, all come from somewhere, from above, from people around us. Egregora, as I told in the half an hour ago, and it's our duty to continue to offer. Atlantic Rum means you receive and then you offer. I received at the beginning, and then I hope I offer too. So we let ourselves be guided by certain values we believe in, and if we can in turn generate value. I think this is the spirit of Atlantic Rum. We receive and we generate value after we receive, because first we must to receive. When I are, let's say, in a school, we learn, first of all.
Yeah, that's true. And there's no doubt that you definitely give so much to your community and all that you're around, Ryan, you really do. You have a lot of heart. And I think the one thing also is that you spoke about is being present. And I think throughout this whole thing that we've all been through the past year, we've learned how to be more present with each other in our communications.
Yes, Heather, and you are right. Even we stayed on Atlantic Run, to be honest, 10 days, the best friends, the best communication, but we didn't stay in contact after so many. And I think the future is online from time to time, and 10 days. Unfortunately, you are not my neighbor, unfortunately. You stay at 1 kilometer or more. But the idea is, if we have, let's say, 10 days or 2 times per year to share ideas face-to-face, this Zoom or Zoom online, doesn't matter, had a very had a great contribution, because we stayed in touch more like a communication, scientific. Not only scientific, because we are friends, part of us, empathy, but face-to-face is a different thing. And in my opinion, if we will have, let's hope, Atlantic Runs, I dream Atlantic Run in my dreams year by year, since 20 years or more, by 10 times per year, like dreams. In my opinion, if we will have, let's say, next year, a physical Atlantic Run, we will need also some preparing meetings very often, monthly or doesn't matter, because it will these meetings will prepare us for a higher level discussion on Atlantic Run. I doesn't mean we didn't have them, but due to these meetings, we stayed in touch more. That's a fact.
Yeah, that's true. That's true. Well, to everyone there, and to you, Tryon, I want to thank you for being here with us today. I want to thank our audience.
Hi, thank you,
Heather. We will be putting this on YouTube so we can continue the discussion and continue sharing and listening. And thank you, everybody, for being present here with us. And I'm wishing everyone the best. And you, Tryon, until we meet again, goodbye, everybody.
After 8. Meet after 8. Bye-bye, everybody. See you soon. Bye-bye.
See you later.
See you later.